A historical flight has taken place. Sikorsky announced on February 8th that a UH-60 Alpha model Black Hawk helicopter flew for the first time entirely unmanned, that is, without a pilot, as part of the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency's Aircrew Labor In-Cockpit Automation System, or ALIAS, program. UH-60 Black Hawk was said to be retrofitted with the Special Flight Control System, which flew the aircraft independently of any human pilots. ALIAS is currently being tested on 14 different U.S. Army aircraft. This unmanned flight was specifically using a Black Hawk that was fitted with Sikorsky MATRIX, an artificial intelligence technology that also forms the ALIAS. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why UH-60 Black Hawk's unmanned flight has a significant impact on future conflicts. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s. And go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The Sikorsky UH-60 Black Hawk is a four-blade, twin-engine, medium-lift utility helicopter manufactured by Sikorsky Aircraft. Sikorsky submitted the S-70 design for the United States Army's Utility Tactical Transport Aircraft System, UTTAS, competition in 1972. Named after the Native American war leader Black Hawk, the UH-60A entered service with the U.S. Army in 1979 to replace the Bell UH-1 Iroquois as the Army's tactical transport helicopter. This was followed by the fielding of electronic warfare and special operations variants of the Black Hawk. Modified versions have also been developed for the U.S. Navy, Air Force, and Coast Guard. In addition to U.S. Army use, the UH-60 family has been exported to several nations. Lockheed Martin-owned Sikorsky and DARPA have been working on ALIAS for roughly 6 years. Till now, there was always a pilot in the aircraft, even if the helicopter performed the flight entirely on its own. Igor Cherepinsky, director of Sikorsky Innovation, told reporters during a February 8th virtual press briefing that there's a switch in the helicopter called the 210 switch. The switch indicates how many pilots are present in the aircraft. For the first time before the flight, it was turned to zero. For 30 minutes, the ALIAS Black Hawk flew without anyone inside over Fort Campbell, Kentucky on February 5th, and then again on a shorter flight on February 7th. The aircraft performed pre-flight checks, took off and ran through a simulated light detection and ranging LIDAR system depicting the congested and complex New York City skyline. The 14,000-pound aircraft navigated autonomously to the simulated skyscrapers, flying through Manhattan, according to Cherepinsky. Then the aircraft landed by itself. A Lockheed Martin press release says, "To demonstrate its ability to adapt to a variety of mission environments, the uninhabited Black Hawk navigates at typical speed and altitude through a simulated cityscape, avoiding imagined buildings while route replanning in real time. All the while, onboard sensor simulator provides real-time obstacle data. ALIAS integrates a high level of automation into manned aircraft and has the capability to take up additional functionality. The company statement said, "ALIAS aims to support execution of an entire mission from takeoff to landing, including autonomously handling contingency events such as aircraft system failures. Easy-to-use interfaces facilitate supervisor-ALIAS interaction." Stuart Young, program manager in DARPA's Tactical Technology Office, said, "With reduced workloads, pilots can focus on mission management instead of mechanics. This unique combination of autonomy software and hardware will make flying both smarter and safer." DARPA and Sikorsky have together invested roughly $160 million in the ALIAS program. "The plan is to wrap up the program by the end of the year," Young said. He added that the split between the two was relatively even. ALIAS brings operational flexibility to the Army, Young said. "This includes the ability to operate aircraft at all times of the day or night, with or without pilots, and in a variety of difficult conditions, such as contested, congested, and degraded visual environments." Viewers may note that a major cause for U.S. Army aviation mishaps is a combination of human error and degraded visual environments. This is the same in other countries too. In December 2021, India lost its Chief of Defense Staff, CDS, in a helicopter crash, and initial investigations indicated that poor visual condition and potential misjudgment from the pilot was the cause. So a program like ALIAS could help offload the burden on the pilot in complex environments. Technically, ALIAS would allow the U.S. Army to fly in conditions that normally ground a helicopter. The system could ultimately be integrated into the Army's future vertical lift programs as they continue through the development process. Young and Cherepinsky said DARPA will transition the capability to the U.S. Army so it can kit out its current and future fleets with customized autonomous capability. While it remains to be seen if ALIAS ever replaces human pilots fully, the ability to help crews make better decisions or multitask in demanding conditions could ultimately save lives and improve the overall reliability of missions. It's likely that more tests will be carried out on different platforms so as to rid ALIAS of niggles and bugs, and it remains to be seen how things develop in this space.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.